Hello everyone, welcome to Alchemistry. So this is my first video showing face, so hello everyone. So in that video I'm going to discuss about nomenclature of heterocyclic compounds. Those who have not watched my first video about nomenclature, the basic organic chemistry, please watch this, then come to watch this. Now, in case of heterocyclic compounds, first of all, we can divide it into two parts. Means, in that video, I am going to discuss about the heterocyclic compound containing only one ring. And in my next video, I will discuss about the heterocyclic compound containing about two rings which are fused. Now, coming to the point of one ring compound. In case of one ring compound, there you can see that one ring heterocyclic compound means without carbon and hetero atom is present. So without carbon or hetero atom can be nitrogen, oxygen, sulfur, anything it can be. Now first of all, to name that compound, we have to know few things. So that I will make four column. So I am making here four column where I have four headings. First of all, I have the heading ring size, then I have whether they are saturated or unsaturated, and then I have written that saturated with nitrogen atom. Okay, so here you can see when we have ring size 3, so we can say that saturated ring is irene, and when we have ring size 3 and unsaturated, then it is irene, and like that way when saturated and nitrogen is also present, then it will be iridine. Like that way when ring size is 4, okay, so you can see when ring size is 4 and saturated, then you can say that etane. So you can't say that etane, actually you can use etane after the name. So how to use that etane or irene thing, I will tell in the example. Now suppose ring size is 4 and this is unsaturated, then we can use it or when this is saturated and both nitrogen present, then we can write etidine. Like that way when it is a 5-membered compound and saturated, then I can say olein, but when it is unsaturated, then we can say only ol, or we can use the word ol here. Okay, so in that case when this is with nitrogen, then oleidine. Now when the ring size is 6 and saturated, then I can say irene, and when ring size is 6 but it is unsaturated, then only in, I-N-E, in. Okay, let's see for ring size 7. For ring size 7, it will be saturated, so it will be epane. And for ring size 7, if it is unsaturated, then it will be epine. If the ring size is 8, then saturated, then it will be okane. And in the similar way, if this is unsaturated, then this will be okyne. Now you have to follow that column all the time when you are naming a heterocyclic compound with where only one hetero atom is present. Now it will be clear when I will discuss this through a example. Let's see, my first example will be a pyridine compound. Okay, in that pyridine, the ring size is 6 and there is nitrogen. Now, if there is nitrogen, now we have to know for each atom what is the name. For nitrogen, it will be azo. And the ring size is 6. When the ring size is 6, you can see, and this is fully unsaturated compound. When it is 6 and unsaturated, then it will be in, I-N-E, in. So for pyridine, it will be azine, A-Z, as for nitrogen. And for 6 member, it will be I-N-E-N. So for pyridine, the name will be azine. Okay, azine. Now, in my next example, you can see this is furan. Furan is a 5-member ring. Now, furan have oxygen. And oxygen, the name for oxygen is oxo, oxa or ox. So OX is the name. Now for furan, it is 5-member ring and the name is ox. 5-member ring and furan is unsaturated, so it will be oxol. Oxol. In that same manner, for pyrrole, it will be azole. As for nitrogen, for 5-member ring and unsaturated, so ol, O-L-E, so it will be azole. Like that way, for thiophene, it has sulfur as heteroatom. So for sulfur, it will be thio, and for 5-member, it will be ol, so it will be thiol. So you can see how a nomenclature can be done for one ring compound with one ring compound and with one only heteroatom. Now we will see that one ring compound with two heteroatom. So when there is two heteroatom, so you have to know which heteroatom will get preference. To know that, we have to know that preference order or the priority order. So you can see here, according to priority order, first will come oxygen, then will come sulfur, then silicon, then nitrogen, and then phosphorus, then sulfur, selenium, nitrogen, phosphorus, silicon, and boron. And their name as well will be for oxygen oxa, sulfur thia, for nitrogen aza, selenium for selena, for phosphorus it will be phospha, for silicon it will be sila, and for boron it will be bora. Now the thing is, what we will use then. To use this, we have to know example, right? So here we have an example. We have a 5-member ring and we have that ring oxygen and nitrogen. So in between oxygen and nitrogen, we will get preference to whom? To oxygen. So we are getting preference to oxygen, so we will write ox first, then nitrogen will come, so we will write as first. So ox, as, and 5-member ring and unsaturated, then ol. So what is this? This is ox azole. So first put the name of the heteroatom, that will be ox, then nitrogen comes, that is as, and then put the corresponding name for the ring according to ring size. Means it's 5-member ring, it will be ol, so it will be ox as ol. So the name for that compound having two heteroatom is ox as ol. Okay, so in my next video I will discuss about the fused ring compounds where two ring will be present. So thank you for watching. If this video is helpful to you, please like, share, and subscribe. And thanks again. Thank you very much.